The ocean is vital to life on Earth. It's home to 80% of the biodiversity on our planet, and it provides the nutrition and livelihoods for billions of people.
The ocean makes up 70% of the surface of the Earth. It provides the oxygen for every other breath we take. So protecting the ocean is not just protecting the planet, it's protecting our own lives.
The ocean is under threat. Destructive fishing is destroying ecosystems and impacting on the economies of local communities. We know that biodiversity is in decline, and this is in the main because we don't understand the extent and scale of human activity out at sea.
There's a lot of barriers to making the kind of progress that we need to make on oceans right now. And data and transparency about what's happening in the world's oceans are central to that. A recent study by partners including Global Fishing Watch showed that 75% of the industrial fishing that's happening on the ocean is unreported or unregulated. If governments can't see that activity, there's no way to set the rules, much less enforce them.
Global Fishing Watch was born as a technology platform. Our technology is now proven. We can see globally what's happening on the surface of our water.
The work that Global Fishing Watch is doing to make the invisible visible, using satellite technology, using the radio signals, using remote imaging and sensing, and the data and analytics that go alongside that, provide a really powerful new tool for protecting the ocean.
More than 3 billion people depend on fisheries for 20% of their protein. Millions more depend on it for their income. It is a sustainable resource if managed properly. The problem is, at the moment, we are not managing that resource sustainably. Global Fishing Watch are firm advocates of public vessel tracking to understand exactly where vessels are operating out at sea. So an open and transparent system where vessels operating on the sea have to share their position and have it publicly available would change the game because they know they're being watched, so it would deter bad behavior. Where there is bad behavior, it would become very apparent very quickly.
Tracking is a really important first step that we need governments to take. Second, though, is making that data actually available so that people know the reality of what's happening on the ocean. And then they really need to enforce against people who are breaking the rules.
Global Fishing Watch is working at several levels to promote and change the way ocean policies are implemented out at sea. We're working directly with nations, but we're also working with international institutions and regional fisheries management organizations. Brazil was one of the first adopters back in 2021, where they chose to share their vessel monitoring system with Global Fishing Watch. This is a huge coastal state. So Brazil using Global Fishing Watch's system to monitor their economic zone creates a better and clearer understanding of exactly what's happening in their waters.
O compartilhamento dos dados no âmbito da plataforma Global Fish Watch foi importantíssimo, porque ele permite que o país atenda um dos principais pilares da gestão pesqueira, que é a questão da transparência dos dados. Então, isso permite melhoria na nossa gestão pesqueira, permite um acompanhamento melhor das nossas pescarias, né, como, por exemplo, ali a avaliação em relação aos regramentos estabelecidos. Então, isso nos dá robustez nas nossas discussões internas, né, para que a gente possa avançar nessas questões.
If you think about the government of an under-resourced, perhaps lower middle-income country, trying to control its fishing activity in order to provide healthy food for its population, they really need tools and information to be able to regulate that asset. By bringing tools like Global Fishing Watch to governments, they're able to, at much lower cost, monitor what's happening, make decisions wisely, target enforcement resources, identify partners.
Global Fishing Watch believes that vessel tracking is fundamental to any good ocean governance. What I'd like to see is a clear mandate, a framework around vessel tracking with a minimum set of standards that every member state or country has to follow. That can really change the way that we understand our ocean, make sure that it's healthy, resilient, and resourceful for the years to come.